Hey everyone, it's Saturday the 16th of December and it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Right, today's video. I have got a very large box of model railway stuff to have a look at. I've only seen what I can see in the top. I've not had a dig around in it or anything. The diecast guy messaged me and I've literally just got back from picking it up from him. But before we look at that, there's two Barricade lamps that I want to show you and two retro light fittings that I rescued about 2 weeks ago. We'll have a quick look at those first. But before that, I've got to clear the worktop. I've got some Lego on there because a couple of days ago I actually bought a very large container full of loose Lego, which is something I have not done. Actually, it's only the second one I've bought this year. I've tried to stay away from buying boxes of loose Lego because I've got at least three tubs in that lounge already just full of loose Lego that needs to be sorted. But I made two exceptions this year. One was about 8 months ago when I bought a smallish tub from a charity shop full of vintage Lego. And this exception that I bought 2 days ago, because it was literally just round the corner from here, quite literally. If I walked, it would have taken me about 5 minutes. But it was also, it was ridiculously cheap for what was there. There's a hell of a lot there. Like I said, it's a very large box. He was only asking £45 for it, which, like I said, was ridiculously cheap. And a lot of what you're seeing here actually came in. The rest of it I've actually spent the last 2 days sorting through it, which has actually motivated me to get some more of the other stuff sorted as well, because I got to thinking there's a lot of tubs in that lounge that I could get rid of if I just put all the Lego bricks that are in it, you know, where they're meant to be. So I've started to do that. I've started to sort out the other loose boxes of Lego as well. The other boxes of loose Lego when I can get my words around the correct way. Grammar in English never was my strong point in school. Better than math though. I did do better in English than I did math. Anywho, that tub was so big, and it wasn't a full tub, but there was still a hell of a lot there for 45 quid. In fact, when I got there, for an extra fiver, he threw in all of this that he'd found up as well, all this old 1970s era train track from Lego. So I've got more of that for the collection as well. I need another box. I don't know if I should go at QD's and get some more tubs. There's over 20 of these Lego castle windows in here as well. So it's well worth the 50 quid, because I did find some very nice vintage, well, what I call treasures. Some nice rare pieces and some parts to a very early 1970s Lego train in there as well. Right, that's given us some space. Turn that around. Actually, I can move these. Might need that bloody thing going to beat you off. I hate bread tags, pain in the ass. And the little sticky tags that seal up the bread bags. That's a bit of a shame. It's just a completely empty battery box. There's not even any contacts in there. And I didn't find any either. So that's a bit of a shame, but no big deal. I have actually ordered some parts that I need to complete the Lego train that was there, because that wasn't complete either. I needed the black motor. And I thought I needed one of the magnets, and then discovered I've actually got the magnets, so it was... Well, there's a job lot of bits that I found. I had the motor, I had the battery box. Actually, I had two different motors, a battery box and whatnot. So, no big loss. And I've got some spare bits for another train. Right. I've been buying more majorettes as well. I think that might be a double. I can't remember. And I've got a nice shiny Toyota. Yeah. Nice shiny chrome Toyota. It's actually a miracle I've not opened them yet. Okay. I'm going to start with this one. It's a DAKS architectural light fitting, D-A-K-S. Now the first one I saw of this, I must have been sort of around 10 years old. It was a lot shorter than this, it's like half the length. And I have got the base for one that's half the length. You did have a bulb with it when I bought it, but the bulb was broken. I didn't realise that till I got it home. I've rescued that one from the local recycling centre, from their reuse shop. It's still sealed in the pack. Anyway, yeah, let's get this one. Yeah, they call it an architectural light fitting. You can still buy these on eBay. They're not common, though. And from what I understand, they weren't actually that common here in the UK. They were more for, like, you know, over on the continental Europe. You know, France, Germany, etc. What is it when you think of Europe? They're the first two, at least they're the first two countries that come to my mind. Anyway, but like I said, you can still buy them. If I want to buy this, you know, new old stock on eBay, the cheapest I found with the lamp was £43 and some odd pence, and that's not including the shipping. So, yeah, I'm glad I rescued this one. I might try, I've got a flex here, so I might try and put a flex on it. See if it works. Let's see if I can get the lamp out without breaking anything. Now these are actually quite clever. There's the lamp. And no, it doesn't have a filament at either end, it's just that centre contact on each end. That does the contact, so this bit is, you can touch and it's dead, or should be. It's literally just a contact, your filament goes down, and then another contact. A bit like the old glass strip lights, which I've got loads of. But this is sort of double switch. It's got a safety switch here. So when the bulb is removed, that switch is in the off position, so it's disconnected, so your power's connected straight into this. And then, when you put the bulb in it, depresses the button, turns on this switch, which then sends power out to your pull cord switch. So that just means when the bulb is out, it doesn't matter if you stick your fingers in here, you shouldn't get be that one, you shouldn't get a shock, because the other side's your neutral, which I'm assuming just connects straight through. But anyway, let's just I've got a screwdriver, I've got some flex. That's not flexible. I've got a pair of snips here as well. I'm going to need a bit of extra cable. And yes, I am sort of, kind of, trying to rush this because I am eager to look through that box. I doubt I'm going to keep everything that's in there, but I do know at least two people I could give some to. So, I don't know what yet. And just to keep things as a surprise, if I do, I'm not going to say what I'm going to give away in the video. Or to who. I accidentally caught that live wire, so I've got to pull down a bit further than I wanted. That is the one side to doing it with a pair of snips like this. You do risk cutting into one of the wires, but if you give yourself plenty like I do, it's not a problem. Shouldn't be a problem. Ooh, my fish tank's got quieter. The air pump was noisy, but I rejigged it on the towel that sits on just to try and dampen the sound down, and it's finally got a bit quiet. Maybe it moved on the towel, but it was a lot more noisier than it currently is. Right. There's also a flex grip here as well. So, neutral is going to go to this side, I presume. There was a flex attached to this, but I pinched it for this big light fitting that we'll have a look at next. Right. Oh, I've bought myself something else as well, which is downstairs, because it can't come upstairs. I now own 3 pedal trikes. Yep, there's found another one on Marketplace. Actually, I found it a couple of months ago, so it's been on there for a while. I just thought, you know, I actually quite like it. I don't know if I'm going to sell it on or what yet, because I did ride it back and I did quite like it. I need to make some adjustments to it though, but I did like it. I've also noticed that I do say I quite like it a lot, and I have to say I'm actually starting to annoy myself with it. So if I do annoy anyone because I say I quite like it quite frequently, I do apologise. Right, I've just got that chucked on. I have got to repair these because they broke when I took it down. So plug it in, switch it on, and there we go. Nice strip light. Now you can get LED equivalent lamps for both size of these, for the short ones as well, so I want to get one for my short one. At some point. Which tells me they must still be a common thing, at least over in, you know, the continent, for companies to make LED equivalent lamps for them. Because if I was a lamp company, I wouldn't want to make anything for, you know, a lamp that nobody bloody uses anymore. That'd just be pointless and a waste of money. Anywho, then I've got this big old thing here. This is heavy, this thing, because these are actually glass. I've got LED bulbs in, so it must have been used fairly recently. And it's literally just your 3 neutrals and your 3 lives into a little connector block. Plus your earth, which obviously just for testing purposes, I haven't got that connected. I have checked the wires over, they're still nice and pliable, they haven't dry rotted or got damaged or anything, so I'm quite happy with those. But I've actually got 2 of these, and I do want to at some point put one up in the flat, at least one. Maybe in the bedroom, because I do want to change in there, but I'm not sure how I'm going to do it, because I haven't got the fixings. That's the problem when you find stuff like this in the rubbish, you know, you've usually got a hope and hell's chance of finding any of the fixes for it. So I'm going to have to make something. There's a bolt or something that goes up through the middle. There's also a drawing pin that just randomly falls out of it, apparently. Yeah, see, there's a hole up there. So I was thinking, I've got long screws, very long screws actually, more than long enough to go through there. So my idea was to cut just a piece of ply, about yay big, something like that, with a hole screwed in the drilled in the middle for the wires to go through, and then what I would do is screw that to the ceiling, obviously the wires going through and connect it all up first, and then just put a long screw through here into the bit of ply. And obviously I would actually have to offset it, so the hole for the wires would have to be over to one side like that, but it wouldn't be a problem, I don't think, because obviously if I put the hole for the cable right in line with this hole, then I've got nothing to screw into, have I? It's a pity I didn't have the tools for metal work, because I could have done a little metal plate, although I'd have had to have used a grommet for that, really, wouldn't I? Anyway, let's plug it in and we'll have a look at it lit up. Ding! There we go. I think that looks nice. Oh, and these arms in the middle, they're actually wood. And the whole lock can be taken apart. There's a nut on each end here. There's nuts in the middle, so you can take the whole thing apart. You can take the lamp holders out. So if I ever did need to rewire it, it's easy enough to do. Right, now the last thing I'll show you on this one is, if you just tilt it up like that. These shades, they just twist off like that. Yeah, the glass. I think this is the one that's got the loose lamp holder, unless all of them are loose. I can just... There's like a headless bolt on the end here, on the outside. I think it's like a self-lock, I'm a bit like a carriage bolt. There we go. You know, I just turned it to tighten it up. Simple as that. Asda LED bulb, so someone liked to shop in Asda. There we go. You just lock that on like that, and when you turn it, tighter again. I couldn't resist it. It's a very 1970s style light fitting. Needs a good clean and a good polish. But I just couldn't leave it there. Thought that was too nice to leave. Right, barricade lamps next. So we've got two of those. First up, we've got this bloody heavy thing. So that was an eBay purchase after a friend of mine on Facebook dropped me a link, because he'd found it, because I swear he looks for lamps on eBay more often than I do. Because I think a number of the lamps I've bought are his fault, because he's linked me to them. Anyway, the seller had two of these on separate auctions, and the bidding started at 25 quid. And I won both. And they were sold as spares repairs, because they didn't work. And they are Julian A. McDermott lamps, American, Jersey, New York, and it's got Jersey Central lines on this metal tab there. Now, I have got both working. The other one has got a short fault on it, though, but only when I put the big metal battery contact plate back on it. There's a short there for some reason. It seems to work fine when I take it off, and then when I put it back on, it just stops. Anywho, other than that, does work. And the weird thing with these is they should have two bulbs in. This one's only got one because I can't get the second part to work. Well, I can, but it was so dim I barely noticed it was lit. Anyway, if I just turn the switch on at the back here, which is literally a hand screw, there we go. So it might have just the one bulb in that works, but what are you doing? But to me, in my book, it's a working lamp. I'm happy. And that does actually require, it won't work on one. It does require two of these. All metal construction as well. I was actually thinking of doing a full restoration on one of these, as I've got two. Or if I can get the other one fixed up properly, I've got one to trade. I'm really surprised no one else bid on them. I was the only bidder. And you found a bit of plastic to chew on, haven't you? I don't know what it is with him and plastic. Snowy doesn't bother. She's not bothered by plastic. Smudge, on the other hand, he's got to chew on. Anywho, last lamp at the moment is this Listen Monolight. Now, I've got a number of these in with the yellow body. But not one with the red and white body, which is why I bought this one on eBay. Oh, that American lamp, by the way, was from a UK seller, not from America. I dread to think what the postage would have been. For a plastic-bodied one like this, you're looking at about 30 to 40 quid to ship it here. So that would have been two metal ones. So I'd probably been looking at close to 100 quid. Anywho, yeah, again, a UK seller, but there was that. Yeah, the main reason I bought this one is because of the different body colour. But it is different to my other amber ones. My other amber ones have got two switches. It's got your on-off switch and a selector switch to select between steady and flashing. This one doesn't have that. It's just got the on-off switch. And the only other one of these monolights I've got with an on-off switch is the sign light, the white one, which is obviously just steady. Because you don't really need a light to flash when it's illuminating a sign. But there you Yep, we're in position. Why don't you click? There we go. It's got a solar cell on it as well. I can't really do it because I haven't got a light. Yeah, it does go off. In the light, it's not bright enough in here. Go on, mister. What are you doing? One moment. Sorry about that. While I was dealing with the phone, I got myself a fresh can as well. So I've actually noticed with a lot of lamps, regardless of brand, that have a solar cell, the brighter it gets, the slower it flashes until it turns off, and the darker it is. Did you see that speed up? Did you notice it? If I take my hands away, it flashes slow. Put my hands back. You know, I just thought that was an interesting feature. I'd love to know why they do that. Unless it's just because of the gradual change in resistance from the photosensitive resistor, which is what a photocell is. It's just, it changes its resistance according to the light. Right. Done all the lights, we've done that. I think it's time for the model railway stuff, and I might actually have to just readjust you. This is a big box. Hi-yup. There's rolling stock. There's at least three locomotives in here. And there's some transformers and stuff. And I think it's mostly scenery stuff. Well, I've already said that up there are some transformers and things in here, but I'm not sure I'm going to be able to use these on my power supply yet, because that, to me, looks like a US plug. We have got a... It's Lima, so it might be European, but I didn't think European plugs had the square pins. Plugs need some repair, will it? Love the cord grip on it. Ha! Oh, that is cool. That's a battery pack. Say who that's made by. Made in Hong Kong. Yeah, it's just a 4D cell battery pack. How cool is that? That's pretty cool. We've got two of these. Again, it's an American or European style. Maybe Italy just used this style of plugs. But I always thought that was a US style. Let's just check what the voltage input is on it. That will give me a clue. It'll work on ours, 220, 240 volt. So it's this one that's got the plug on as well. Yeah, same input voltage. I just want to check that before I put a UK plug on to try them. I'm not going to do that in this video though, because I just got a feeling it's going to be a long video. Who's this? Oh, just like a fake grass mat. What is this? This is Lima, so I'm guessing this is some sort of Lima controller. I'm not sure how you connect the wires to it though. Output 12.5 volts. Yep, power unit. It's not telling me what the bloody input is. Oh, there it is, 220, 240 volts AC input. 50 or 60 hertz. So you could use that in America with a step-up transformer. Just the hertz don't matter, apparently. What is this cat trying to do? Just don't fall through there because you're sitting square on that bloody flap. Right. Now. We have some track. Some nice long straight tracks, which I think I will keep them. Simply because I still want to make an end-to-end shelf layout in the lounge, as well as the one in the bedroom. So I'm going to need some track for that. Got some track ideas there for small layouts. Upside down. Quite a few ideas actually in here. Hornby Railways, train set operating instructions. Oh, so it's actually instructions from a train set. Sweet. But I'm more interested in the rolling stock. So I'm just going to go through it and I'll bring it to the camera, then I'll just stand it on this worktop. I might actually just slide the box that way a bit further. So the first one I've picked out. Can't see a maker on it, but I think it's Hornby. Grimsby Fish. There's actually a chap on Facebook I know who comes from Grimsby. What's the next one? Scottish Beef. Four Sainsbury's. And LHB, I think. It's just a flat wagon with a couple of containers on it. Oh, it's even got the detail plate there, look. This has got a wonky wheel, so it's not going to run straight. There we go, I just popped it back in place. Ah. This is going to need some repair work. I think this is Lima. Yep, because Lima like to do the plastic ones. I don't know why, but I've got a Mercedes. Possibly a Mercedes, I'm not sure, it's just a truck and trailer. Right. Now this caught my eye. And I actually think from the feel of it, these are both motorised units. Yep, that one is. No, that one isn't. That's got a weight in it then. So, my second intercity. Well, actually, that's my third intercity. That's just my second one in the yellow and grey. I just realised this is yellow and grey, not yellow and blue. So, this isn't the Swallow Livery. Ah, so I've actually got three different ones then. What are you trying to do with that bit of paper? You? Oh, you're pouring it now. Right. Well, it looks like we might have the full intercity set because I've got the coach there as well. Well, I've got at least one coach. I don't know if that one particular one came with one or two coaches. What else have we got? A couple of these. And I know I'm going to want at least one of these to go with my BR Green one. But I don't know which one yet. I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe this one is a Mark 1, I think. Actually, no, they both could be Mark 1s. In that case, then, if they're a pair, I might keep them ones for my BR Blue in the city. What else we got? I don't really want to do the... the thingies. Yet. There is actually a loco that's gone walkabout and I can't see it. I know it was in here and I picked it up and then put it back in. It's just a little
040. Pretty certain it hadn't dropped out anyway. You'll be a bit miffed if it is, because I doubt I'll find it. Anyway, there's another one that looks like. This one may have been modified to have lights, because I can see little red in there. That one may have had it, and I can't remember the class. Class 33, that's it. Right. It's a little 040 look. I might actually have to go for a ride and see if I can find it a little bit. If it's fallen out, someone must have picked it up. I can't see how that would have fallen out, though. That's a Sheffield, what is it? Amgu? No idea. I've got a little Shell one as well. There's another one. I've got a small rake of Shell tankers now, at least. We've got another Lima lorry trailer here. Not Dunlop. I think I've got a Dunlop one. I'm not sure. Let's just pull a handful out so we can get through it a little quicker. So I've got a couple of different hoppers here. I've got Amy Roadstone there. And just a brown one. Probably again for some gravel or something. They look identical apart from the colour and the name. And lack of name. We've just got a big truck here full of coal. And I like how that top bit is all sort of all uneven, like it would be on a real truck. Oh, we're missing a set of wheels. No worries, because I've actually got plenty of spares. Oh, we've got a Yeoman hopper here as well. And a Bolsover truck. Over, I found a loco. We've got a little SO tanker that needs a little bit of repair. I need to just glue these back on. We're missing a ladder. Oh, there is no ladder. So it just needs a few bits stuck back down. I think we'd be good for that one. We've got here, we've got an anthracite, Evans and Bevan. Anthracite. And lemon juice from Jif. I don't know why you'd want a truck to carry lemon juice, but here we go. Hot one. Pull out another 3-inch. Oh, that seems to be. That's a box car, this one, but it's missing the roof. It might be in there, but we've got Kit Kat. Lima brake van and a Giggleswick Swindon Sidings Rylestone LMS PW Spencer truck. There's a heck of a lot written on that. That's an assortment of trucks. And another one. And what the hell is that motorized? I think that is actually motorised, that's going to be interesting. Right. Have a look at that loco in a second, I just want to get the other bits of rolling stock that's on top out of the way. So we've got two of these NCBs. This one has actually got a couple of wheels missing. Again, I've got spares. Another little truck which has also got a set of wheels missing. JK Harrison and Co. St. Pancras and Marylebone. Marylebone? Marylebone? It's down in London. And at least at the moment, just one more bit of rolling stock and that's whatever this is. Watney's. What's Watney's? Anybody know? There's a little shed on the end of it here as well, look. And here's the 040 Loco. I wouldn't be at all surprised. Wheels are definitely going to need a clean, I can see that, but I wouldn't be surprised if that basically works. But this is not an 040 that I've actually got. Stewart's and Lloyd's Corby. I do like that colour on that as well. But then again, I've got a soft spot for these little 040s. I don't know how many I've got in the collection now. Oh! We've got no wheels on it, but we've got legs. Is that just a flatbed to put containers on? No wheels on it though. Here. That ain't no good, that's a bit of scale extra. Got some signals, and whatever's in here. Shall we have a look? What we got? I actually have absolutely the foggiest what that is. It doesn't look like there's anything complete. Oh, there's bits of signal box, maybe? Or a line side shed or something? I might be able to make something with what's there. I don't know. I'm running out of space already. Alright. We've got some bridge sections here. Seem to just slot together. Who are they made by? Is it Hornby? Yep, so far three bridge sections. A couple of bits of Hornby platform here for a curve. Might actually be handy for my layout, the curves. As I want to use that style of platform. Oh, there's another bit for the bridge, so we've got four of those. We've got, I'm sure that's Scaledale, isn't it? Because it's plastic. Made in Great Britain. Got no glass in the windows or anything, but it just looks like a little waiting room or something. This intrigues me though. Although the belt is not doing anything. Is that meant to do anything? Is that meant to just... get it to do anything. I don't know if it's just a bit stuck. Oh, that freed it off. Look at that. I don't know if you can see that. That does work now. So it's just a conveyor belt for something. I suppose it wouldn't be too difficult to motorize it if you want to. You could if you wanted to motorize it. I can actually see a couple of ways you could do it. That's nothing to do with model railways. I've no idea what that is. It looks homemade though. It looks a bit like a bus shelter or a football stand. Yes, that's not nothing to do. I'm assuming these go with this. Yep. Yes, it does actually. Perfectly. So we've even got the uprights if you needed them. assuming then that, yeah, these two bits go with it as well. So we've got the uprights, we've got some lower ones here as well. Ah, we have got a boatload of track in the bottom. I've got a few of these. I don't think I've actually got a use for these on my layout. I don't know. I'll keep a few just in case I want to use them on the shelf one. Oh! Ooh, I wonder if the rest of this is in there. That's the top for one of them cranes that grab containers and whatnot. Very well be. Look what I've found. So that would go on there. Now I just need the supports. Scale railway kits. That's from Ratio, but I don't know what it is. Coach wagon and signal kits available. So what have we got here? Signal kit. Oh, that's what that is. That's a signal kit. It's, I don't think that's anything that I could use. I'm seeing lots of bits of yellow in here. This one's going to need some major repair, I think. Yeah, that goes with it. There's another one. I'm assuming that goes with it. I think. Possibly. It's going to be a bit of a jigsaw puzzle, I think. So we've got some of these. I have. Looks like just a corner bridge of some sort. Yeah, it is. So you put your curves on it. You slot the track in. Because I see the little tabs for the track to sit under. Like that's been. I think these few bits might go with that conveyor. Maybe. It's Lima. Little tunnel, a very short tunnel, and we've got some grass and stuff here as well, and some coal. I don't know, this looks more like fish tank stuff. This looks more like fish tank stuff. Or a vivarium or something like that. That's what I think that is. Right, now we've got some more. That is what I needed that I didn't have. Not as plastic, but no, a little bit of painting here and there, that'd look alright. Ah, that's the hopper piece, you know, for them hopper wagons. You could put your track across the top, then they would dump their gravel or whatever through there, straighten up the hopper. Probably above that conveyor, I guess. These look like track supports. A couple more bits of platform. Don't know what that is. There is a number of what look like some sort of track support here. Number of these. And a bit of a broken grey bridge there. Oh, that's a bit of the grey bridge, maybe I could fix it. Not seen these for a while. Yeah, little decoupling bits. Meant to decouple your wagons and whatnot. And the rest is telling fibs. You've got this. That's rigging. I know what this is for. It's for this, isn't it? Yeah. That's got to be the rigging for that. We've got a fair bit of that. So maybe these track supports go with... No, but I've got some more of it. I think I've actually got a complete bridge there. I think I would need 8 in total, so maybe I've got 2 more. Yeah, I have got all 8, so... looks like just a bag of bits. I don't know what is in it. That's not helped, because I still can't see what's in here. Found a missing wheel. A few other little sort of knickknacks in there as well. Not worth going through that. I've actually got just the body for this one. I haven't got the wheel bits. Now I've got a complete trailer. I do believe, apart from the knickknacks in here, like a track connector and a few other little bits. I don't know what that's for, or do I? Kind of clicks in. Got a buffer there. Yeah, it looked like for the most part, the rest of it is just track. There's another set of wheels. Some more wheels. Ow. Ah! I know what these wheels go to. They're for the truck. Random bit of plastic. Random empty bag. Mostly curves, that's all it is. No, some of these have got what look like copper fish plates. Okay, yeah. I'm going to keep hold of that. It looks like a fairly decent track connector. Keep these wheels aside as well, just before I chuck everything back in here. piece of lemur track. Yep. Now, how did I know that was a piece of lemur track without even looking at the bottom? Because that's not a Hornby style connection, it's a lemur. I'm not really sure how you're supposed to connect the wires onto that. But it connects the same way as the lemur controller. That's what I've been looking for. I don't know if these are anything to do with that bridge. Possibly, looking at it. But there's a few of these in here as well. That might be just to support the rigging, maybe. Brighton, York, Doncaster, Derby, Crewe, Reading and Swindon. Looks like we've got some water transfers there. Yeah, I doubt they're stickers. And a set of wheels. Ah, it just looks like the wheels have just fell off. Yep, that is it. Oh, I forgot these. Not any other interesting bit in there apart from the track. Some legs for something. Right. Now, let me put the rolling stock back in here yet. Where's... This one was missing a pair of wheels. Let's see if I can... Got some wheels on but not quite popped into place. Got it. But what else was missing? And I would love to try and get this one assembled, but I really do not know. So I'm going to go a certain way up. Is it missing some bits? I think it might be missing some bits. No, there's no other yellow bits in here. I don't know what these are, but there's a couple of them in there. Don't know. Right. Ah, yeah, this was missing. I got this one. Knock the wheels to the floor. Yep, and the same wheels. Just pop in nice and easy. It's because the bogies are a bit flexible, I think, so they drop off a little bit easy. And get one in to sit in and just try and... There we go. A little bit of wiggling, they'll soon drop into place. Was there something... I'm sure there was at least one more that was missing a couple of wheels. Well, I've buried it all under there now, haven't I? I want to keep the bridge stuff separate. Grey stuff there, I'm not sure. Could have swore I had four of these, not three. Oh yeah, it's there. See if I can assemble that bridge and just see what it looks like. It doesn't seem like all of this is here either. I wheel in it's got a wheel missing. Where's the one gone that rolled onto the floor? Or did I pick it up? I might have picked it up. But there's something here. Oddly enough, don't appear to be long enough or wide enough. Oh, hang on. Nope, they are on there. I don't know how well they're going to stay on there, but they are on. Can't remember about the trucks. No, the trucks have got wheels, at least those two have. You've got wheels. That was it. I'm pretty certain everything else has got wheels. Holy crap, I've literally just noticed that these have got the bloody coupling hooks on. And if you're wondering why I sound surprised at that, it's because I am, because nearly every one of these I've got, missing. Just like the two Intercity Locos have. And the coach has got one on it, one on one end. Oh, I think that was a nice little haul. So we got a selection of rolling stock and whatnot that I haven't actually got, apart from trucks. They seem to be one of the most common things, these bloody trucks. That one I want to fix. That, yeah, I don't think I'm going to keep that. Or and be made in Great Britain. Oh yeah, where were you already? Ah yeah, that's what I want the wheels for. Yeah, I think this is one of them flatbeds and you have just a couple of containers on it. What you're missing, but I suppose it's handy if someone wanted to custom build something on it. There's a base there, isn't there? If you put the wheels back on it, it's not got a use as it is. It's got one coupling hook on it. I might steal that and put it on the Intercity. I don't think I'm going to be using that anytime soon, so I might as well. It's all Hornby stuff, look at this. That's got one missing. But yet there's a lemur here, which actually has both, because they know how to put their coupling hooks on. Apparently Hornby does. I've just noticed this one's actually got a coupling missing. I may actually have some couplings that will fit that. We'll just press into that. Right, that is it. So I'm not going to drag the video on any further. There's going to be some more items going to Kat's box. I'm going to ask a friend of mine who's going over to hers for Christmas if he wouldn't mind taking that box with him. Yeah, I was thinking, you know, giving some to my stepdad, but looking at this, I can't see that there's anything here that he'd actually want for his. No, I can't think of anything.
Holy mackerel.
Right, so buried my drinks. Thanks a lot for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the video. You know the drill. If you did, thumbs up. If you didn't, thumbs down. If you did like what you see, then please hit that subscribe button. I've got an itchy nose. You hit the subscribe button. It's free. And don't forget to hit the notification bell as well, so you get notified every time I upload a video. What else? Oh yeah, if you check the video description down below the video, phone users may have to click see more or whatever it's called below the video. But there'll be links in there to my other two YouTube channels. I've got a gaming channel and a Lego channel, which I'm reviving, finally. I don't know why, I've just got the motivation now. I think it's buying that big box of Lego and sawing through it that's given me the motivation. Anyway, there'll be those. There'll be the links to my Discord server, so feel free to check that out and come and have a chat. And lastly, there'll be a link to when I can get my words out. my Twitch channel, because I do want to do live streaming in the new year. It'll be all sorts. It'll be gaming, it'll be a chill stream, it'll be, you know, probably building a Lego model or something like that. Completely random stuff. I'm not going to have a Twitch channel for each bloody YouTube channel. I can't be bothered with all that. It's just going to be a one for all. Just like my Discord server is, it's a one for all. So, again, thanks a lot for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye!